Hello?
It is time to play.
Music for the people, making music for the people. Light shines bright everywhere we go.
music for the people to illuminate the soul. Light shines bright everywhere we go. Music for the people, Jesus, music for the people.
You gave me the stars, put them out of my reach. Call me the waters a little too deep. Oh, I've never been so aware of my need. You keep on making me see it's way beyond me. It's way beyond me. Yeah, it's out of my league. It's way. Strength to do. In over my head keeps me counting on you. I'm leaving the sweet spot, short shot, trading it all for the plans you got. Is this so crazy to believe that you gave me the stars, get them out of my reach?
swinging for the fences. It's like this heart is defenseless against a passion that's pumping through my veins. Blood, sweat, tears, it's a calling. And if I can't walk, then I'm crawling. It might flicker, but they can't kill the flame. I can't stop, I can't quit. It's in my heart, it's on my lips. I can't stop, no, I can't quit. It's in my heart, yeah, I'm on it. Till the wheels fall off, till the spotlight fades, I will lift your banner high. I will lift your banner high. Until the walls crash in for the rest of my days. Every minute, every day. So in the middle of the madness, they can stretch me out like canvas, but I ain't ever gonna fit in their frame.
Till I die and they put me in the coffin, yeah. Don't matter if I'm on the road or if I'm recording. Tell me what you think about me, that really ain't important. You know I'm a representative, I ain't playing, can't afford to. I only got one life, I'ma get it though. And this is not an act, not a movie, not a TV show. I don't know what quit me, I don't never take it slow. You know I'm on the ground, me and Toby in the studio.
Go for the king, what you know about that? Say you going harder,
I
yeah, you say you doing work, but you asking where the couch at. How you doing work when you asking where the couch at? God is not a crutch, you can use them when you wanna. You only look to heaven when you going through some drama. And when they going through some problems, and that's the only time you call them. I guess I don't understand that life. Wonder why, cause I'm all in. To the day I die,
till the wheels fall off, till the spotlight fades, I will lift your banner high. Lord, I'll lift your banner high. Until the walls crash in for the rest of my days.
Oh, are we on?
Well, oh, I just hit the mic.
We rolling?
Yeah. Hello. Oh.
That's it? What was the next one?
I can't remember anything.
You can go first.
You can go first.
Go? Yeah, go. So, when do we start?
Alright, should I just go? Okay.
I learned how to not only go to my breaking point, what I thought was my breaking point, to push past my breaking point, and how to persevere even when thought I could not persevere, because, you know, basketball's a lot of running.
Yeah. Something that I learned this basketball season is pretty much everything about basketball, because I had no idea how to play basketball.
Oh, something I learned this season is don't give up, because Wes doesn't like that, and give 110% all the time.
Something I learned is kind of like Kate's, like, I did not think, like, I never played basketball before, like, in my life, like, not even just, like, for fun, but, like, with, like, God and, like, our coaches also, like, helping us, like, we, like, even though we haven't, like, won any games or anything, like, we've come, like, so far from, like, the beginning of the season, like, with God, like, you can really, like, do anything, because, like, we, like I said, like, we didn't play basketball at all.
So you can do all things through Christ who gives you strength. Yes.
I think Wes is a good coach, although sometimes he does run you a little hard. He does mean well. He does. He's just trying to make you better, trying to get you the way you should be, and he's just trying to get you there.
I learned the sport of basketball. I did not know anything about it before, and I was actually anti-girls basketball. I did not want to play it, but one scrimmage gets the boys, and I was in love with it. So I learned everything there is to know about basketball, and I love it.
Something I learned in the season was I didn't know anything about basketball, and I learned all of it in just a couple months.
I learned that just never to give up, even when you're tired or you're just mad, you just never give up and you keep on going.
What I learned from this season is you have to really trust your team. Now, in other sports like volleyball or soccer, things like that, you have to trust your team a lot, and you know that they're always there for you. But in basketball, it's really important because you have all these people like right up on you, and you need a teammate there for you. But so, anyways, sorry, I'm like getting off track. But so, I think just trust is a big thing. You have to have that bond with your team. You know, you have to have a relationship with them. You can't just, you know, try to do it on your own. Just like, oh, here we go. This is like a Bible reference. You know, just like how you can't do things on your own, you need God's help. Well, you need your team's help in basketball.
I like Coach Wes because he's a good coach and he never gives up on us and he always believes in us. And he always makes sure that we know that.
I didn't know anything about Coach until we were first starting practice, and whenever I got to meet him more, he just became to be a good friend and an awesome personality.
Something that I learned is everyone has a designed like position. Like, everyone has their own position. We all have our unique talent, and yeah. What did you learn?
I don't know, I think I definitely learned that I had a lot more endurance physically and mentally, I guess, than I thought I did. So I kind of learned that about myself, and I feel like I got to know a lot of the team better. So.
Yeah, I feel closer with even the boys. Like, I got really close with DeAndre, Johnny, Frankie, like, just all of them. Like, I'm just like, we're one big family.
Yeah, you're just getting involved with the other team.
Yeah. I like him.
What I learned this season was just being around the boys. It was just like great camaraderie that you get from being around, you know, friends and everything. You can grow closer with being friends and just knowing each other better. Just the great camaraderie that comes with just being on a basketball team is really what you can get out of this, what I've gotten out of this season.
Like Grace said, you do need to trust your team because they always have your back. Like, if you mess up, it's okay because nobody's perfect.
Coach Wes is a great coach. He's shown me a lot through the years, and he's taught me a lot of life lessons, and it's like, it's crazy. You know, I almost feel bad that, like, we're not winning games for him, but I wish we would just all, because we owe him a lot. He is a great coach, and I couldn't ask for anything more, so yeah.
Thank you. something I learned this season. Well, I definitely learned that I learned that you can't double dribble. I learned you can't do that. I learned that you can't be too aggressive with the other team. And what I learned about Coach is that he'll always be there for us when we need to learn something or when we're struggling.
The thing that really left a mark on me that Paige said was even if you don't want to give 100% for yourself in a game, give 100% for the team. Because there's players that want to give 100% every single time and are pushing themselves their hardest just so they can be good at it and help the team. So even if you don't feel like it that day or don't want to give 100%, still do it for your team members.
I got to know the girls a lot more because I wasn't really social. I'm not social. Exactly. I'm not social ever.
Always have fun even if you don't win, and play your hardest even if you have the low score.
I would say one thing I learned this season was teamwork's probably the most important thing. If you don't have teamwork, you're not gonna be successful.
I learned that you need to really be aware of your surroundings while you're playing, because your team, if there's a bunch of people on you, like Grace said, then you're gonna need someone to come help you. And you just really need to reach out to your teammates and be helpful for them too.
I believe that camaraderie with the team is cardinal, and that when you play basketball, that you should always be looking around to see who's open. And I didn't think I was going to play basketball this year, but
neither did I.
Friends convinced me to play, and I didn't know that I really like playing the sport, and it's really enjoyable.
Well, what I learned this season is that teamwork is very, very important, and that if we don't have teamwork, games that we do have teamwork go a lot better than games that we don't have teamwork. And, if we're arguing or anything, it just doesn't end well. So we need to stay focused, and when we're together, we do a lot better than we do by ourselves.
The funniest moment would be when we stretch before practice, Brendan doing his ankle rolls on the ground. It's just because he's on his stomach and his foot's out and he's doing it real weird. It's hilarious. You have to see it.
Was just being here and having fun with the guys, on the team and everything. Just being here is just a lot of fun on the basketball team.
Funny moment was in our first couple of games, Brendan would always be on the floor and he would just always, be on the floor even if he got the rebound or...
Yeah, I just think it's funny when Brendan's bringing up the court because Wes is like, oh no. And then Brendan's just funny.
I have to say the funniest thing this season is probably seeing every time Brendan gets the ball, he's on the ground.
One thing that was funny this season is every time before practice would start, we'd do these stretches, and Brendan Statler would do his ankle rolls, and it's ridiculous, but he does these little faces, and it's hilarious.
Probably one of the funniest things that happened this season was guys would tell me to do these weird ankle rolls or whatever. They'd ask me to do it every practice. I just did it one practice messing around, and they make me do it every practice from there on out.
Favorite memory. Okay, so we had these little preseason practices, boys and girls co-ed. I didn't even know what Indian runs were. We were doing Indian runs.
You don't want to know what they are.
You don't want to know what they were, yeah. And I stopped and I stood in the middle of the court while everyone else ran, and I was like, I'm not doing this, I'm not playing basketball. And I texted Paige that night and I was like, I'm not playing. She goes, Deshaunee, you are playing. You are joining the team. And Wes was like, Deshaunee, you're playing, you need to do it. You're just gonna get better. That's my favorite memory.
My favorite memory, well, it's not my favorite memory, but it's kind of funny because it was actually today at our pep rally for the first time ever in Calvary Chapel history. It was fun. And I went up to do a game, and I have anxiety, and I was shaking so bad, and I had to blow up a balloon, and I was shaking, and then I had to push it, and I was shaking really badly, and so my excuse was oh, I'm out of breath for blowing all this air in this balloon, but really I was just so nervous, and I won, but
Because, you know, girls are better than boys.
Well, it was like a Friday and we were scrimmaging with the boys and I threw the basketball and I was the first person to get the ball stuck on the hoop.
The funniest memory that I have of basketball, it was like one of like the first practices and I think we were doing like layups and my sister cannot do a layup and she dribbles up to the basket and she like throws the ball and it hits the corner of the of the backboard. Comes straight down and like smacks her in the face. And she falls like straight back onto the ground and then she jumps up and is like, oh, I'm okay. And then like started practicing again. It was really funny.
I thought it was awesome when Kate Zahedi scored a three-pointer at the, like it was right at the end of the game. Like the buzzer literally hit when she started to throw it. And then it, like, I was so nervous. And then it finally got in and she like fell on the floor. And then she like started laughing, but it was like a nerve, I don't know what she did. She was sort of like sitting down and then she stood back up and then she sat back down.
I think the one thing that I actually thought was like the funniest that stood out, I'm pretty sure you were there, was whenever Kate Zahedi made that crazy shot.
Yes, that was the best memory.
She was like halfway down the court and she just threw it and made it in and she screamed.
It was like High School Musical. It was like everyone jumped up.
It was such a
and we were all like, woo! Like it was,
we all ran up.
It was so awesome.
She came back, we were all standing like this and she just goes
and like, well, yeah, we were like all in tears. We're like, yeah, I can't say anything. Like she's like melting down. Like
it was so funny.
It was the best.
That went on for like probably a good like 5 minutes.
Yeah.
I think this was like our first game that this happened. I'm not sure, but I think it was. I remember. Okay, well, all of us we were pretty bad shots. I'm just saying. Like I mean we've come a little way, but you know we were pretty bad. Never came to like shooting far away and things like that. So. And I was bad on layups in general, just close shots. So I was just bad at shots anywhere, okay? But so I think it was our first game, and there was about 5 seconds left on the clock. And I'm sorry, I'm getting off track. Hang on. Okay, and Kate Sadie, our point guard, was coming down with the ball, and so we only had a few seconds, so whenever you only have a couple seconds, you have to hurry up and shoot. And so she decided to go for a three-point shot. And we're all like, oh man, this isn't gonna go in. And all of a sudden, as soon as the buzzer goes off, it swishes right in the basket and we were all freaking out. We were all like jumping up and down and we were just acting like little children. It was really funny, but that was probably my favorite moment of the season.
So the funniest thing that happened this season is one of our games, there was like 30 seconds left on the clock and I had the ball and I didn't know what to do. So we were dribbling around and passing and finally the ball came back to me and there was only like 2 seconds left. So I had to shoot. It was completely lucky. I made a three-pointer and I looked at my feet and I just fell to the ground right when the buzzer went off. And so everybody came around me and started hugging me and it was like the happiest moment ever. And I went over to Paige and my coach and Paige said she was gonna pee her pants. It was so funny because she was legitimately felt like she was gonna pee her pants because she was so excited. And so that was the best memory and funniest memory for me.
Here I remind myself what you said over me. Here I remind my soul who you are. You said you won't relent, won't let go, won't forget every promise you have whispered to my heart. As I wait, as I wait on you, I'm gonna run and not grow weary. I'm gonna walk and not grow faint. Rise up on wings like eagles to soar. I know in everything you're with me. I know you're working as I wait. Lift me up on wings like eagles to soar.
desert holds a song, I will sing on and on. You're a river when the ground I walk is dry. You will set the crooked straight, clear my path, make a way. You will lead me from the valley to the high. Oh, as I wait.
Yeah, probably Brandon. You never know.
Was it?
You, if anybody.
Me?
If anyone.
Yeah, it would be me. It would be me. Yeah, it's me.
I'll be Brendan.
Oh, that would be Ryan.
Definitely Brendan, of course.
Grace.
Probably her.
That'd be me.
Grace.
These scales?
Grace scales.
Never eat fiber one bars before a game. It's just
or sun chips.